Ladies and gentlemen, we found the famous Dean Laux. How you doing today,
Andrew
sir?
Hey, Steele. It's great to see you out here. How does that happen?
Yes, sir. Likewise. So you've got your bus, your new bus that we saw in Vegas. It's got some red in it. We know you've got some plans to change it to blue. What's coming next?
You know, this is real difficult for me because I've got to make this thing better than what it is now and not just change the red to blue, which would be the easiest thing and the least expensive, but you know, turn this into an artist series and then almost think about it in a way that if I was going to paint this for myself, what could I do with this by changing it that I even wouldn't have done in the beginning?
Yeah, well, I think folks are excited. So I want to ask you a few questions today. Doing a color change, now you're going to go above and beyond on this. Now, do you have people that just bring coaches to the Art of Design for just color changes, or what all have you guys done there?
That's a common thing. Somebody will buy an older coach. So 2012 or earlier, we did not paint every coach. So if an older coach is purchased, Liberty, and you'd like a color change on it, we can do that. Usually around $100,000 is this kind of starting point. Now you could do an artist series, you could take it out above. There's options that can just, you know, add more to it. But the general cost is around $100,000.
People are probably wondering, $100,000, that's a lot of money for a paint job. There's probably other RV shops, like back in Elkhart where your shop is, probably do it a lot less. What are some of the things that you guys do that would be different than other shops that would justify that extra cost?
So you have to remember, when you're talking the money, you're talking time. You know, we're selling our time. And we just don't come up with a huge dollar amount or any dollar amount, and it just is. It's been because of the time it takes to get it there. So if you look at the 1,200 to 1,500 hours that it takes to do a new Liberty coach, at $100 an hour, it should be $150,000 for a paint job. So, you know, just at $100 an hour shop rate, that kind of falls into place for the new paint job. By the time you add in materials and you get another $15,000, $18,000 in materials, then really that's a good deal to get a new paint job for the number of hours we're putting in. Now, you know, other manufacturers put in half the time.
Yeah.
There's no way to compare the detail or the quality from something that was done in half the time to something done twice the time. Our guys are working all the time, you know, and they're very good at what they do. So we don't just invent time. We want to get the thing out the door, but it just, to do the quality we do, takes the time.
What are some of the details in this paint job that we wouldn't see in other RV paint jobs?
So this design is unique in itself because when I was designing this one, I was trying to make a pattern area a stripe. So that means that a pattern is something that's broke up into different shapes. A checkerboard could be a pattern. In this case, these kind of straight stripes with detail going on inside, when you come up close, they look like big blocks of color. You stand back, and all of a sudden you see that it starts up here, and it comes down here. And if you look at the front, you can see a point at the top, and it widens out as it gets to the bottom, goes through the wheel well. Well, that's something unique and different that we invented that hadn't existed before. So you have that pattern that is kind of, you see the black on top, you see this pattern, and that's kind of the first thing you notice about the coach. But then you start looking, and there's ghosted patterns, like this shape right here.
Oh, yeah.
There's a ghosted shape in there, there's these shapes. And this gets to be very, very difficult to do this color on top of that color while it's changing.
Oh yeah.
This color here, if you look at this section.
Yep.
And this section are two different colors.
Yep.
This is even a little brighter. So it's very difficult when you get tone on tone. So maybe, you know, the difficulty on this, besides the pattern and all the clear and the sand and the prep and everything else we did, is the tone-on-tone colors.
So what are your future plans? You're getting ready to put this under the knife and change the colors, make some pretty big changes. What can we expect to see here in the fall?
Well, I sent you just here recently some pictures of what it's going to look like. And I think I've decided, I started this when we bought the coach. I did some initial designs. and thought, okay, I'll just keep taking it further and further. Well, you get to the point where it's too much, and then you back off. But I think I got the one I keep going to, and that's, I'm trying to use the advice that I tell others. Lay them all out. Lay your designs out when you get them. Walk in the room and just see them fresh for the first time, and your eye will start going to one. Then that's probably the one you need to go to. You may be forcing yourself to grab another one, but it's like if your eye keeps looking at this one, that's probably it.
Please drop a comment below and let me know what design you like best, number 1, 2, or number 3. We greatly appreciate your feedback.
What's your vision?
Yeah, so you see, this is interesting. We've got the red pinstripe here, and then we've got, look how thin the white one is.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you can, yeah, I mean, I've got to get a real close-up to see that there's just a little pin right there. Yes, sir.
And then this red pin is a different size than this red pin, but then you have two different colors. So what happens is you have to paint the red areas and then cover those up. Then you immediately have to take and paint it the white areas and cover that up. And then you can start painting everything in between. So different size pins and different color pins makes it more difficult. I'm trying to think of this as being the base. Like if I was in a progression and wanted to take this further, that what I have here is already good. So very little of it gets erased. But this does go to blue.
Uh-huh.
All the red pins go to blue. All this other stuff stays the same. But I am adding a stripe right through here that goes along with this stripe and comes up, and it'll be blue. There'll be some other stripes that come along here that get added, and you'll have to show the rendering of what I'm looking at doing in the end. I really liked in my last coach that the top awnings were white.
Yeah.
And I think that really lightens up the coach and doesn't make it feel so dark. Then we got stripes, of course, that are going to be painted on the windows that we do for the artist series. And then I got to think about the textures and the artist series part of what's going into the design now. And that's the next part that some of it may just happen when I'm doing it.
We're looking forward to seeing it. When do you think that we will see the new renderings?
Well, I sent you the rendering, so you've got the design, and you'll be able to show everybody maybe that on the video. Then after that, the coach will be done in late October. And we're working with some new products that are going to go on the coach and the trailer that nobody has ever seen, has not been available for a motor coach before. And I think this is really going to be exciting to hit this next year with these new products.
I did get a sneak preview at some of the stuff that Dean's coming out with. I'm sworn to secrecy right now, but definitely keep an eye out for some of that stuff coming soon. Now, when we were back in Vegas, I did do the full tour of this coach, so I'll make sure to leave a link to that video in the description below if you want to see the full tour of Dean's new coach, if you haven't seen that already. But you think around fall, we'll be able to see the finished product?
Yep, about the end of October. I've got everything open after Sturgis. We drive home and immediately start prepping the coach and getting it ready for paint.
If someone has an RV and they want to do a color change, kind of like what you're going to do, now you only paint Liberty coaches, or do you paint any other RVs, or how does that work?
Well, we repair any coach. So if you want ceramic on it, you want a color sand and buff polish, you have some paint chips, you want repairs done, we can do that on any coach. For a full paint, we stick with Liberty Coach.
Is there a reason that you just stick with Liberty Coach?
Well, you get better at things when you just stick to the same thing. So the same product line, and of course our relationship with Liberty goes back to the mid-90s. And one thing I really respected out of Frank in the mid-90s, when we wanted his business, he was loyal to Prevost. And their paintwork. And rightfully so, because there's so many evils that can happen with paint if someone doesn't prep it right, or they don't mix the colors right, they put the hardener in right. You can have all kinds of issues down the road. So we would get the real exotic paint jobs that Frank would have come through at Liberty Coach. Florida Marlins, Brassfield Wine, Randy Travis's buses, a few other stars that we worked on. And so we would get those throughout the years. And then I think he'd get them back in, and 15 years later, there was no paint issues, you know? And so finally, it was the right timing in 2012 for us just to work together and just take over and do all of them and set what they do with the interior and the detail in the inside, be able to add that to the outside.
Well, Dean, I'm really looking forward to seeing what's coming up next. If you guys haven't already subscribed, make sure to subscribe around fall time. We're going to show you the magic that Dean works on this bus. So, Dean, any other advice that you might have for the folks out on YouTube that may own an RV and be thinking about getting a color change done?
Buy a Liberty so we can paint it for you.
Awesome.
Take all your worries away.
Absolutely, absolutely. But Dean, I can't thank you enough for taking the time to share everything you got going on with me and the folks out on YouTube. I also greatly appreciate all of you out there subscribing to the channel and liking these videos. I hope you're all having a great day. Thanks again.
Thanks, Andrew. Thanks, everybody. See you soon.